Good day mga ka-CRT. Welcome again to Electronics Lecture Series. This is Season 1, Episode 10 and the topic is Zener Diode. Zener Diode, it is a type of voltage regulator for providing stable reference voltage for use in power supply, voltmeter, and other instrument. The schematic symbol for Zener Diode is this. So ang kinaibahan nito sa rectifier diode, yung symbol sa cathode side. So this is the identifier for the Zener diode. Then let us discuss the VI curve, the voltage current characteristic of the Zener diode. This device is designated to operate in the reverse breakdown region. So ang Zener diode, ang common operation is using the reverse bias condition. If the diode reaches reverse breakdown, its voltage remains almost constant, even the current changes drastically. If operated in forward bias, it acts the same as rectifier. But dito sa graph, ang main highlight ng Zener diode is to focus on the reverse breakdown region. So ito yung i-highlight natin sa mga susunod na discussion. Yung kanyang reverse breakdown region. There are two types of breakdown operation in Zener. These are the Zener breakdown operation occurs in a Zener diode at low reverse voltage. The breakdown voltage in this operation is less than approximately 5 volts. Avalanche breakdown operation. It occurs in both rectifier and Zener diode at sufficiently high reverse voltage. The breakdown voltage for this operation is approximately greater than 5 volts. Commercial Zener diode are available from this range, 1.8 up to 200 volts. The tolerance, 1% to 20%. So, gaya ng nasabi kanina, ang main focus natin is the reverse breakdown region. So, ito, i-magnify natin yung reverse breakdown region. Meron siyang tinatawag na reverse current. Ito na yung Zener current. And ipe-breakdown natin sa three types yung Zener current. Okay, so we have IZK, IZT, and IZM. So IZK is the Zener ni current. Ito yung minimum na Zener current. And andyan din yung point ng transition. Okay, from low current papuntang high current. Okay, next, IZT is the Zener test current. Okay, ito yung rated Zener current. Then IZM is the Zener maximum current. From the word itself, this is the maximum Zener current in the reverse breakdown region. And also, take note, kung naka-properly reverse bias ang Zener, yan. Ang magiging equivalent niya is a battery with this polarity. Okay? So, nagets ba yun? Kung nai-apply nyo yung proper biasing ng Zener, which is reverse bias, mag-a-act yan as battery with this polarity. So, positive na yung katapat ng cathode and negative yung katapat ng anode. Okay? So for the Zener impedance, take note that the Zener impedance is equivalent to the change in the Zener voltage over the change in the Zener current. So like for example, we have two Zener voltage, this value and this value. So meron yang change in the Zener voltage. Then correspond to those voltages, merong mga equivalent Zener current yan. Okay? So, pwede nating i-label na 1 and 2. Then, magkakaroon ka ng change in Zener current. So, yun ang gagamitin or pwedeng gamitin to determine the Zener impedance, yung ZZ. Pero normally, ang Zener impedance, given naman yan. Okay? Nagagamit lang itong formula na to to calculate for delta VZ. So, i-cross multiply lang delta IZ multiplied by the impedance, Zener impedance. So, next slide tayo. Let us now consider the following formula. Okay, so ganito siya i-analyze. First, if okay, the Zener current is less than IZT, so ibig sabihin, nandito banda yon, yung IZ. If it is less than with IZT. So pag ititrace nyo yan, may katapat yan na VZ, which is obviously this VZ is also less than the rated Zener voltage. So actually itong VZ dito dapat VZT. And then itong point na to, ito yung Zener voltage of our concern. So yan yung hahanapin natin or i-represent natin using equation. So again, if the IZ of our concern is less than IZT, we can represent or calculate the VZ of our concern equivalent to, so since yung VZ is less than VZT, magkakaroon tayo ng minus operation. Ano yung ima-minus natin? Ima-minus natin yung delta IZ multiplied by the impedance. Okay? Or this is VZT minus the change in IZ. Uunahin natin yung IZT. Then minus ng IZ multiplied by the impedance. Okay? So next natin. If the IZ of our concern is greater than IZT. So sa graph, nasan yun? Sabihin natin nandito. This is the IZ greater than IZT. Okay? So paano naman natin isosolve yung VZ of concern? Pag tinrace mo yan, yung VZ of concern is greater than the rated Zener voltage, VZT. Therefore, magpa-plus tayo. VZT plus the change in Zener current times the impedance. So this is VZT plus yung change in current ngayon, mauna ngayon yung IZ of concern. Minus the IZT and then times the impedance. So yun yung mga equation na gagamitin natin para sa related examples dito. Okay. So let's move to the next slide. So dito, meron tayong given na Zener diode 1N4736. And ang mga given na parameters, unang-una yung IZK, 1 milliampere, IZT, 37 milliampere, the impedance, 4.5 ohms. Okay? So ito ay naka-ohms. VZT, 6.8 volts. And the power of the Zener maximum, 1 watt. Okay. So first requirement is the IZM. Hindi given yung IZM, pero pwedeng isolve. From the equation of the power, general form or equation of power, power is I times V. So meaning to say, we can calculate I using P over V. Diba? So dito, apply natin, since we are solving for IZM, so ang numerator ay PZM. Zener power maximum. Over, yun nga lang, ang denominator natin na voltage, this is VZT ang gagamitin. Yung rated Zener voltage or the test Zener voltage. Okay, given naman ng VZM, this is 1 watt divided by VZT, 6.8. Okay, calculate nyo lang. And this is approximately equivalent to 147 milliampere. Okay? So next question or requirement, calculate VZ at IZK. So yung IZK is less than the IZT. Therefore, ang gagamitin nating formula to solve for the VZ, okay, dito natin isulat. VZ equals VZT, diba? Balikan nyo lang yung formula kanina, pero ang gagawin ko rito, substitution na. So, VZT minus the change in current, ang change in current na i-apply natin is IZT muna, which is 37, minus IZK, which is 1. Factor out na lang ang milliampere. Multiplied by the impedance, which is 4.5 ohms. And the result here is, perform nyo lang yung operation. Okay, VZ here is 6.64 volts kung 2 decimal places. Okay? Next, calculate VZ at IZM. So, since ang IZM is greater than the IZT, balikan nyo yung equation natin kanina sa previous slide, i-calculate yung VZ equals VZT, which is 6.8, and then magpa-plus tayo. Magpa-plus tayo ng change in current, in this case, mauuna yung IZM. So ang IZM na-calculate kanina 147. And then minus IZT 37, factor out na lang yung milliampere times the impedance 4.5 ohms. Okay? So i-calculate niyan, this will give you 7.295. So kung 2 decimal places tayo, 7.30 or 30 volts. So yan yung solutions natin for this example. Okay, so next. Another set of example. So if the Zener current is 25, this IZ of our concern is less than IZT. So to solve for VZ here, okay, VZ equals VZT, which is 6.8, minus natin yung change in current. So, mauuna ang 37 and then i-minus natin yung given na 25 milliampere times the Zener impedance, 4.5 ohms. And this is equivalent to, calculate nyo lang yan and apply natin ang 2 decimal places, 6.75 volts. Then sa baba, calculate VC at 50 milliampere. So this IZ is greater than IZT. So therefore, yung hinahanap na VZ is VZT 6.8. Magpa-plus tayo. Then change in current, unahin natin yung 50. I-minus natin yung IZT 37 milliampere. Times the Zener impedance 4.5. Perform yung calculation and round off the two decimal places. This is equivalent to 6.86 volts. Okay. So next slide. Okay, for this Zener diode circuit, mag-recall tayo or mag-generate tayo ng mga equations or formula. So this Zener diode is a regulating circuit. Okay. Ito yung mga equations related to this circuit. So kung mag-KVL tayo rito, magkakaroon tayo ng equation na Vin equals VR, nandito yung VR, voltage across this resistor, plus VC, nandito naman ang VC. Okay? Across the Zener diode. While ang VZ, nakaparallel yan sa load. Nandito ang load. So kung parallel, VZ equals VL, and by Ohm's law, VL equals the load current IL times RL. Okay? Then gamit naman ng KCL using this node, current entering is IT equals current leaving IZ plus IL. So ito yung mga equations for the Zener diode regulating circuit shown. Okay? So let us solve some related problem. Alam naman natin ang Zener ay isang regulator. So kaya niyang mag-regulate even na nagbabari ang input or nagbabari yung load. So for this example, let us consider varying input. So determine the minimum and maximum voltage that can be regulated by the circuit shown. Okay. So sa ganitong problem, sinisimulan natin ang solution at IZ minimum. Ano ba yung minimum Zener current? Di ba yung IZK? Ang IZK natin, given yan, ito yon, 1 milliampere. Okay? So, isolve natin yung VZ using this Zener current. So, ang VZ, this is equivalent to Zener voltage, ito kasi yon ano, yung VZ, ito rin yung VZT. Kapag hindi sinabi mismo na VZT, yan na rin yung VZ, the rated Zener voltage. So ang mangyari, 5.1 minus the change in current, ano ba yung change in current at this calculation? Iba yung IZT, which is 49, minus, yan yung current of concern natin, 1 milliampere times the impedance 7. So ang masasolve natin dito, calculate nyo lang, this is 4.76 i-3 decimal ka, 4 volts. VC pa lang yan. Hindi pa ito yung inahanap nating minimum. Okay? So, ang inahanap natin is the input voltage na kaya niyang ma-regulate. Simulan natin sa minimum. From the previous slide equation, Vin is equivalent to VR plus the Zener voltage. Okay, yung VR pwedeng Ohm's law, I times R. Okay? Then yung I, ito na yon yung 1 milliampere. Then yung R, given naman siya 100 ohms. Ito yon. Plus yung VZ at this IZK equivalent sa 4.764 volts. So therefore, the input minimum is equivalent to this solution. So i-calculate nyo lang, this is equivalent to 4.864 volts. So ibig sabihin, ito yung pinaka mababang value para mag-produce siya ng regulated amount na 5.1. Kasi ang magiging regulated voltage niyan, itong given na VZT, 5.1. Okay? Sunod naman, ito na lang, siguro kasya naman dito. Or dito ko na lang muna. At IZM. At IZM, hindi binigay yung IZM. Hindi rin binigay yung maximum power. So pwede nyong i-assume na ang maximum power ng Zener ay 1 watt. So isolve muna natin. 1 watt, i-divide natin yan sa VZT, which is 5.1 volts. Calculate nyo to, express nyo sa milliampere. So this is approximately 196 milliampere. So hindi ko na sinama yung decimal places. Yung two decimal places. Ito na lang yung gagamitin natin. 196 milliampere. So this 196 milliampere is obviously greater than IZT. So pag ganyan, masosolve natin ang VZ equals, ano nga ulit yun? The VZT, which is 5.1, magiging plus naman to. Kanina, 5.1 minus. Pero dito, sa condition ng current, plus. Then the change in current, unahin natin yung 196. Imo-minus natin yung yung IZT, which is 49 milliampere. Therefore, imo-multiply pa pala to sa 7 ohms. And this is equivalent to, solve nyo lang, no? 6.129 volts. So, saan natin gagamitin yan? Gagamitin natin yan to solve for the maximum input that can be regulated. So, ganun ulit ang equation, VR plus VZ. And this is IR plus VZ. Yung I na gagamitin natin is yung IZM, which is 196 milliampere. Times the resistance, 100 ohms pa rin, plus yung VZ, nakakasolve lang natin, 6.129 volts. Okay? So, isolve niyan. And this is 25.729 volts. Okay, so ito naman yung maximum input na pwedeng ma-regulate. So, mean to say, yung from 4.864, ito yon, hanggang 25.729, ito yon, ang output mag-i-stay or regulated sa 5.1. Okay, so naintindihan ba yon, guys? I hope naintindihan nyo yung concept or yung discussion related to this example. So proceed naman tayo sa next example. Ito naman, varying yung load, yung load resistance. So determine the minimum and maximum load that will maintain the regulation. If VC equals 12 volts, IGK equals 1 milliampere, IGM equals 50 milliampere, and the impedance is 0. Okay. So sisimulan natin ang solution using this formula. V in, okay, minus IT, the total current, times R minus VZ equals 0. So saan nakuha yan? Pag nag-KVL ka rito. Yan. So from this equation, pwede nating ma-solve ang IT. So i-derive niya lang, IT is equivalent to V in minus VZ over R. So ano ang V in? Given yan, ano? Kita naman dito, 24. Minus natin ang VZ, yan yung rated Zener voltage na 12. Over the resistance, ito yung resistance, 470 ohms. Okay, so this is equivalent to 25.5 milliampere. So ito yung total current ng circuit natin na yan. So ngayon, pwede na tayong mag-solve for maximum RL or load resistance. Ang una nating gagawin, i-consider natin yung minimum load current possible. Ano ba yung minimum load current possible? Ito yung zero. Okay? So from KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, ano nga yung equation natin? The total current equals IZ plus IL. So kung zero ang IL, lumalabas class na IT equals IZ, which is 25.5 milliampere. So ano ang indication niyan? Okay? So ang indication niyan is this current, this is below the maximum rating. Okay? So ano ba yung maximum rating? So 50 milliampere. So pasok yung maximum rating. So pwede nating gamitin yung lowest possible IL, which is 0 ampere. So to solve for RL, mag-ohms law lang tayo. Diba? VL over IL. Ano ba ang VL in this case? Sige nga. Kung naiintindihan na itong circuit na to, isipin nyo muna. Ano kaya ang magiging VL? So since nasa regulation tayo, if the Zener voltage is 12 volts, yan, given naman yan, ito, nakaparallel yan sa VL. 12 volts din ang VL. So therefore, 12 volts over 0 is infinite or open. Ano pa? Or no load. So ito yung maximum possible condition na pwedeng makapag-regulate yung circuit natin. Okay? So ito yung maximum. Pwedeng infinite, open, or no load. Next, for minimum, pagkasyahin natin dito. For minimum load resistance, gagamit tayo ng maximum IL or load current. Okay? Therefore, ang mangyayari dyan, magiging minimum naman yung IZ. And this minimum IZ is equivalent to IZK, which is, ano ang IZK? 1 milliampere. Ayan. So, ang next na gagawin natin, kung meron na tayong IZK, isosolve ulit natin yung IL. Di ba ang IL na gamit na natin kanina, this is IT minus IZ. And in this scenario, IT is still 25.5 milliampere minus IZ, which is 1 milliampere. So ang lalabas dito, 24.5 milliampere. So saan natin gagamitin yan? I-ohms law natin yung RL. Di ba? Ito yung VL, which is 12 volts, over IL. Itong ang kakasolve lang natin. 24.5 milliampere. Okay? Then ang masasolve nyo dyan, 489.80 ohms. So ito naman yung minimum na resistance or na load. Para makapag-regulate siya sa 12 volts. So ibig sabihin din, below 489, hindi na siya magiging regulated output. Pwedeng bumaba na rin yung 12 volts. Okay? Okay, so hanggang dyan yung discussion natin ng Zener. I hope na-refresh kayo at may mga natutunan kayo about the concept of Zener diode as regulator. And if interested din, meron kaming LX Green Book. So ito yung mga topics niya at available siya sa Shopee. So puntahan nyo lang yung shopee.ph/CRTcovalent. Meron din kaming ECT Blue Book para naman sa pagre-review for electronics technician board exam. So ito yung mga outline niya at available din yan sa Shopee. So punta lang kayo sa shopee.ph/CRTcovalent. Okay, so maraming salamat mga ka-CRT. Kung nagustuhan nyo yung aking lecture, please subscribe, like, share, and post a comment in this video. So God bless!